let's say we have five flags, and during Indian Independence Day, we have to give two flags to one student. Okay, so let's say if I give two flags to one student, so how many students can I allot these flags to? So two flags to one, then these two to another, and one is remaining. So I cannot give this flag alone, or I cannot give a single flag to one student, so hence this will be remainder. So if you see, if we divide the set of five by two, so I can take out one group of two there, and I can take out another group of two, but then one, this flag will be left out. So hence I cannot complete the set of two here. So hence we say that if we divide five by two, I get two sets of two each, and one is remainder. This is what Euclid's division lemma explains, that if we had five and we had to give two to one student each, then I can extract out two groups, no more, one will be left out. If I had another flag here, then the two set of two would have been completed, and then I would have given it to three different students. So hence, if I divide six by two, I would get three, isn't it? But if I would have divided five by two, then I would have got one plus one, two. So that becomes my quotient, and this becomes my remainder. That's what Euclid division lemma explains. In this example, if you see, we have nine pens here, and let's say we have to give two pens to one student. Okay, so how many groups of two can I form? I can form this one, then this another one, so two groups, then third group, then fourth group, but I can't complete this group. So hence, what does it mean with respect to Euclid's division lemma? That we can divide 9, so there were 9, I could divide 9 into, let's say, a set of 2s. So how many set of 2s will I get? I'll get 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4 set of 2s I'll get, and 1 will be remainder. So if you see, this 1, the remainder 1, is less than the divisor, which was 2, and the quotient is nothing but 1, 2, 3, 4. So hence, this 1 is less than 2. That's what Euclid's division lemma also says, that the remainder must be greater than equal to 0 or less than equal to the divisor, which is in this case is 2. Now imagine that I have to divide this in the groups of 3. So 1, 2, and 3. So I could get 1, 2, 3 groups of 3. So in terms of Euclid's division lemma, I can say that while if I divide 9 by 3, I'll get 3 as quotient, and there is nothing here as remainder. So this is another example. Another example would be, let's say I divide this group of pen in the set of 4. So how many set of 4s can I get? So that means I'm dividing 9 by 4. So 1, 2. So two sets of 4 is achieved, and one is remainder. So hence, if you divide 9 by 4, 2 is the quotient and 1 is the remainder. Similarly, let's say again, if I have to divide by 9 by 5, so I can create one set of 5. That means if I divide 9 by 5, I'll get 1 as the quotient. So one set I could form, but these 4 are remaining. Now if you notice, what was my divisor here? 5, right? And the remainder is 1, 2, 3, 4, which is less than 5. Now if I would have another pen, then I would have completed the set of 5 once again, and hence the quotient would have been 2, and hence the remainder will automatically drop to 0. Correct? So hence, in none of the cases, there will be remainder which will be more than the divisor, because the moment it is more than the divisor, then you can complete one full set again, and that will be counted in the quotient. The quotient will be added by 1. Right, and hence remainder will always be either. So what will be the remainder if any number is divided by, let's say, 5? So I will be having either 0 as the remainder, or I'll get 1 as the remainder. When will that be? Let's say there were 6 pens, and now I have to divide the in let's say divide by 5. So I'll get only 1 as the quotient and 1 will be remainder. If I would have had 7 pens, then again 1 will be the quotient, 2 will be the remainder. If I would have had 8 pens, then 1 set of 5 and 3 is the remainder. I would have had 9, then 5, 1 set of 5 and 4 as the remainder, right? But the moment I would have had the 10th pen, then I can complete 1 set of 5 again and the quotient gets incremented by 1 and remainder again becomes 0. So hence remainder can go from the value of 0 to 1 to 2 to 3 to 4. That means the remainder values could be anything less than all the integers from 0 to 4. That is what was explained by Euclid in his division lemma.